on, man? It's your boy here, Marcelas Howard.
What's going on, guys? From Marcelas Howard, man.
Marcelas Howard, you're watching
Challenge today.
I just started in. Check. All right, we're about to get it.
Woo! What it is and what's up? Can I play it? Just keep touching.
You're looking past.
Right off the bat, what made you start creating? To be honest with you, how the backyard, you know, how the backyard stuff get going?
Started here. Started in this very locker room in this school. Just got an iPod touch out and was like, record something, like vlogging, doing some stuff I've never seen on YouTube before. I've never seen kids in high school vlogging by themselves at the age of like 15, 16, back in 2011. So that's really started the creative process. And then leading to the backyard, that was just on some fluke stuff. I was literally babysitting the backyard, or backyard sitting, whatever you call it, and the rest is history.
So you know the game they're doing, right?
I don't.
Oh, I thought he told you.
Some musical chairs type thing, he said. So the ball gonna be like on the chair?
Yep.
And then we gonna run around it. And run around and then whatever, when he says stop or whatever, you grab it and then you have to score from the bottom or you take it to the top?
I mean, the cones are there for a reason.
Let me see what this looking like. Hold on. This is part.
Alright.
Testing. Alright.
Ready?
Yep.
Here we go. 3, 2.
What's going on, you guys, from Marcelas Howard?
I just did that just in case.
Perfect. Now,
let's go. The couch or?
Shed. Yeah.
Shed.
Welcome back to another video. Right. Boom, and then the forefront is onto the rules. Cool. Let's go garage, couch. I
had no idea, bro.
So now the S stops. You got you?
The S stops.
Today we got a new game.
Yeah.
And I'll say stop.
Yeah.
Game
time.
Get number one in basketball?
College. So I graduated, got my bachelor's at Home and Navy University, which is definitely a great accomplishment.
Oh my gosh, with the scoop, left hand, that's tough, Sal.
Oh, this is a lefty layup, I remember this.
So that's tough, Sal. The switch left, hey.
In and out burger with the right, that's tough with this. But I did that kind of for my family though. That wasn't really for me, because I didn't really need the bachelor to do what I need to do with social media and everything. I just wanted to be a first generation, and that was what I did.
Okay. So now, I guess fast forwarding, since you've seen you start blowing up and so forth, like, what motivated you to stay in Sacramento? You know what I'm saying? I'm from LA, so what motivated you to stay in Sac?
Man, I'm very frugal with spending money.
Okay.
So LA is really, really expensive. And for me, I like living a slower life. I like to be able to drive anywhere and not have 30 to 40 minutes worth of traffic. And, you know, there's not a lot of stuff to do out here, so I get to control my speed and go at my speed and like the things I do. Instead of LA, it's just quick. And I don't like that lifestyle at all.
Yeah, most definitely.
I get that part. All right, so little bro pulled up, man, and he just doesn't give a fuck. Door wide open. All right, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna do this on purpose so I can show you out. Just leave the shoes out. Let's show you how good my neighborhood is.
Update.
So remember, his door was open. We left the shoes there. We're done filming now. And the shoes and the door are still there. Excellent neighborhood.
Just open all the doors. Who would want those?
You never know.
You got a point.
Just gonna leave it open. We're gonna drive off if you notice this.
Oh, I forgot to close the door as I'm driving off. He's the type, like, if he don't remember doing something, he'll claim he did it and just give you a reason.
He's gonna forget.
But, like, hey, I'd be like, hey, Jamie, why you have all your doors open? Oh, I was just airing it out. This is fake, bro. Y'all prank me.
Nigga, we were filming the whole time. What you mean?
I know where we at, but ain't nobody robbing you.
But I'm saying, we were literally filming the whole time. You had your keys on you, right?
They would have took my gun. I know them niggas. I know they got sneak friends, man.
Or they might have seen the shoes and said, them shit's ass.
It has to be a prank, bro.
How is it a prank?
Why is my lip balm on the ground? Bro, they would have went through my stuff.
They might have. The shoes is on top of the car.
Broad daylight.
In broad daylight, bro. Maybe you left your car unlocked?
Nah. I mean, it probably was, but they would have took the shoes.
It isn't hard. Give me some of the cheeks, bro.
The bot, they probably...
You got plaid on him? We going back to go clogging?
Bro, y'all pranking me, dog.
How are we... Jay, just let me know when we had time to prank. You got dressed before me. We were playing 1v1. I took a shower. I said, hey, y'all want these shorts and shit going through the shorts? I never left outside the garage until just now. And you had your keys on you. So how?
I was...
Niggas tried to hit a lick on your shit and see you had nothing in there.
They would have took some water. They would have took something, bro.
It's cool. You just down bad.
Bro, I know I'm not... They would have took the quarter on the seat.
So you know what's crazy? You have no awareness at all. Your car door was open the whole time, all day.
Dead ass?
So we came here, literally just now, and we're just like this. Open all the doors.
This was open?
Everything was open. With the shoes were right here, so I put them on top. I said on camera, I said, we're gonna go film. Watch, he's not even gonna notice, and the shoes will still be here.
Whoa.
Got caught lacking, nigga.
I could have got robbed.
What is going to be the trend moving forward? Do you feel like, are you the trailblazer? Are you catching on what other, you know, content creators are doing? Or?
I mean, right now, you know, as hot as park runs, 1v1s, open runs, all the stuff I'm not doing.
Yeah.
And people are trying to say, yo, Silly wants you to go out there, like trying to force me to, you know, go out there once again. And then I kind of go back to the old story of how I felt forced to play baseball and I didn't want to do it. But this part is like, I know I'm not doing it because I genuinely don't want to, and I don't feel like it's gonna pay dividends to me, knowing my character.
Yeah.
Cause I get really competitive without knowing it, and I really hate going into that space.
You can't hang with me in 3 dribbles, you know that.
10-1, that's too much space, you have to adjust. Yes. Give me my space.
I'm not gonna teach you to give me my elbow up. You give me my chin. Wash your hands. Before we can turn these cameras off and really do something.
You did that for me, that shit.
Ball game.
That hack is shit.
They do this all the time.
Cell does this all the time. I mean, I haven't been back here with Jay Lou a lot of the time, but I've been back here with Zay. You know what I'm saying? I'm a veteran. Me, Zay, Kayvon. When we get into it, it's just like this.
Yeah.
So yeah, this is, it's just a different person he's doing it with, but I expect this. This happens all the time. Something happens and now he's explaining it. He's like, bro, did you not just, this right here? Did you not just do this? Yeah, that's all right.
So that's why I don't like to do all the competitive stuff all the time. Like if I do it, it's really 1 to 4 times a year total.
Yeah.
Because it's just a different type of sale I don't really like necessarily. And that's why I stay away from
it. How do you balance? How do you feel like you balance the two?
Man, it's tough. I've definitely gotten better at it. But you know, having a good woman on your side definitely helps. Good family on your side, friends. And so people to hold you accountable. Because it's not easy to do it by yourself. It's kind of impossible to do it by yourself, actually.
Yeah. This is the part you're going to have to make me understand.
Okay.
The reaction videos.
Stop this body here. That's too much on the left.
What you getting into right now?
I'm about to react to Kenny Chow versus Ryan the Crash Dummy. They play 1v1. Okay. Ryan the Crash Dummy told me I'm gonna love this video, so and everybody knows me and Kenny have like a long lasting ongoing beef, so this is gonna be hilarious to watch because I heard it's hilarious. So Kenny told me himself, he's like, bro, it was bad. Either way, if he won or lost, it was bad.
Now what made you start, you know, just recording yourself as far as reaction video?
Man, you know, quarantine. So when quarantine started, I was like, let me just try this reaction stuff. And the fans started to fall in love with it. I wasn't really like too head over heels at first because I was like, this is kind of like simple. It's too easy. You know, usually they say the easy way to success is the quickest way to fail.
Yeah.
So, but it wasn't that it was easy. It was already, I've already built a platform. I've already built a following. and they were just gonna go wherever I went, and the reactions was just simple and easy. I even catch myself watching like Cash Nasty Flight, people like that, like Kenny Chow. Like I watch their reactions, Your Rage, and I get caught in myself just watching heck of videos, and I'm like, oh, I can see how people can get like addicted to watching reaction videos, because you just watch one, then it just rolls to the next one, you're watching that. So that's pretty much how I got into it, and now I love doing it. It's like, it saved my life.
Do you think that like your work ethic of like you make being a great basketball player and all that, like what it took to be a great basketball player, kind of goes into why you grind like this?
I think so, man, because I grew up, you know, grinding for everything. That's what Pops always taught me. So like, and being in this room, I see accomplishments all the way from fourth to fifth grade to seventh, eighth grade to high school to college. I see years of work. A lot of people will get a million subs, but you know, they won't admit it. And they'll get complacent. Now, I've gone through that. But then, like, that's why the reactions don't really pick me up, because it was something else. Because now I'm trying to get a million with that. And it's just never going to... Now I'm going to try to get a million with another channel eventually. Keep innovating. That's the way you really grow. That's the way you really captivate your creative self. And then I look to the top and I see my own editions of NBA Live with me on the cover. And, like, you know, you can't really write a better story than that. And, you know, I kind of blaze my own path now where I'm like, I'm just me.
My guy James is coming up, man. It's your boy Marcelas Howard.
And then, like, I got the basketball wall that I see every day, and it's just like the very first one that started it was the good looks. My boy Cam, Cameron, look cool, Mac. Let's see that baseball. So that baseball right there is signed by my boy Mauricio Dubon, plays for the SF Giants, and he went to high school with me. So, like, he's the first Honduran player in MLB history. To my high school, so like seeing stuff like that, it's like anything's possible. Then right in front of me every day I see these three, like my favorite three basketball players ever, all three arguably the goats of all the generations. And then this, and you see the 1 million plaque my girl, or the 1 million tapestry my girl made me for my 1 million subscriber party. And I think that's the biggest staple in the room. Like that's like That's the motivation right there, because nothing's blocking that off. So if I'm reacting, I feel like I'm down or something, I just be like, I just look around. I'm like, I gotta find some inspiration. This whole room's inspiration to me. Everything's in place for a reason.
What's going on, everybody? I'm Marcelas Howard, and I'm the creator.
Okay, let me get on the sandwich thing. Let me not eat it by itself.
You know what you're going for? Like, you eat that.